Phoenix saw his captain and fellow soldiers in the distance. Through a trick of the light, he could almost see them waving and calling to him.
Phoenix! Again! You may not be your brother Ligeron, but I will make something of you yet.
Hold my shield. Try not to drop it this time.
I didn't see you there.
Don't let them get to you. They're just zealous. It's not often someone has a brother like yours.
Lokagos! Lokagos, can you hear me? You've gone cold. What magic is this? Ligeron! Where are you, brother?
Unarmed and lost, Phoenix was vulnerable.
I have to be calm. I have to follow my training. My brother's sword! No! Ligeron! Brother! You've always been my hero, my North Star. I will bring you back. I swear it.
Phoenix had never been allowed to hold the hallowed sword. A gift from Achilles for bravery in battle. It balanced perfectly in his palm, as if forged for it.
Achilles' sword? Brother must have been good in battle.
Is something wrong with your voice?
I never got a sword. Just saying.
Phoenix looked up. He was not alone.
By the gods! Stay back!
He ready for real fight. Phoenix felt his training come into focus.
I should be able to survey the land from up there. This is the largest statue of Hermes I've ever seen. I wonder who built it.
Besieged by challenge, totally alone, this young hero was determined to save his fellow soldiers and brother.
Boring! Can we skip this part?
No. This is important for the sense of atmosphere.
Hermes, my old friend. It's an honor to finally meet you in person. Just don't tell anyone I'm speaking to you. I got in enough trouble for memorizing stories instead of tilling the soil back at home. And then the other soldiers? Well, they really don't appreciate a good story.
Phoenix's destiny was becoming clear.
So far, all you have shown me is a mortal soldier who has fought one real battle, and Typhon grows stronger by the hour. Don't toy with me, Prometheus!
I swear to you that soldier shall be our salvation. For if he fails, and Typhon defeats us, Zeus, King of Gods, the world will fall to chaos.
A temple of Apollo? If it has an oracle or a seer, they could help me undo this curse. A griffin? But they aren't real!
Let me go! Help!
Hey! I'll save you! I'm coming!
I need to find a way to reach that rift.
Life and death. The stranger struggling.
How to get down? The pond!
Phoenix felt Ligeron's blade with every step. Its weight a reminder of the heavy responsibility.
You gave him your blade? Oh, Achilles.
I meant to ask, why exactly would you expect to receive a sword from Achilles?
As an offering. Just a routine offering from someone who gazed into your eyes
and told you you were special. That's all.
I left the rose on his breast.
Got something in my eye. Keep going.
The adamantine shed by Typhon's minions, metal of the gods, threw itself to Phoenix, as if wanting to be forged into something greater. Ha! Muse, sing of Hermes, the luck-bringing messenger of the immortals. He consorts with all mortals and immortals. Little he profits, but through the dark night, he continually tricks.
That's nice. Who wrote that?
My favorite poet, who just happens to not have been born yet.
Who's done this to you?
Prometheus, stop with the mortal pity party and get to the action part.
Fine.
Now that's more like it.
Unlike the mortal flesh, which had been frozen into marble, the pomegranate, sprung forth defiantly, bursting with life.
A lot of poetry for something they just got to stick in their mouth.
Isn't that what the best poetry is about?
I'll have to swim to the other shore.
Phoenix approached the axe, feeling it call to him.
Looks like the axe of Atalanta. It must be a copy. Although...
But before Phoenix could claim it, the axe was pulled into the pit by a terrible force.
Who knocks upon my door?
No one.
You think that old trick will work on me? Come into my parlor. Send the Cyclops to the sailor.